Hello, mantises! Welcome! Welcome to my furious claws of Wolverine Fury! Okay. What is going on, Nerd Paraders? Thank you guys so much for coming back to hang out with us. Today we're playing some more ARK Survive and Evolved, and we're over here on the Scorched Earth server today. We're going to be doing some polymer farming, and we're going to show you the most effective way to farm polymer that you have ever seen in your entire lives. I'm over here with Bamboozers. What's up, buddy?
How goes it?
It goes good, man. It goes good. Okay, so we're here. Oh, yeah, you're bringing... this is some service. You're bringing it right to me. All right, we've got the mantises over here. We're on a Ptera, and we're going to show you it's leveled all in power. We're going to show you exactly how good this is. Boom! One mantis... 400 polymer and 2.6k chitin. Let's take a look at it in the inventory. That is my inventory. Wrong inventory. There's it. One. That was one mantis. And this isn't even imprinted to me. G flippin' G. Okay, here we go again. Smashy, smashy. Come back here, buddy. Smashy, smashy. And that one got 502 polymer. Do you see how absurd this is? This is how we farm all of our polymer, and this is how we're, like, constantly making so many materials. And we figured it was about time to share this amazing method with you guys and talk a little bit about what we have planned for some of our upcoming raids and things of that nature. I am Nick. This is Nerd Parade, guys. Welcome to the channel, and thank you so much for coming to hang out with us today. Oh, we got a twofer over here. We got two mantises for the price of one. We're stuck in each other. We two have become one. And I have just farmed 780 organic polymer from two mantises. Yeah, I like that one the most. Oh, there's three now. This is flipping fantastic. Is that an egg too? We gotta get that egg. We need that egg right now. We need that for rock golem taming. And that's probably something that's also gonna be a thing. Is an upcoming, oh, that was a 120. Come back here. Stay away from my ride. Clicky clicky. Uh-oh. We got that thing that never happens. There it goes. All right, back into the inventory. Let's see what we're doing. 1,000, 2,000, almost 3,000 poly in the time that we've been just rambling on. I think we're like 2 minutes into the video, rambling on about what we're doing, and we've gotten almost 3K poly. Hello, mantises. Welcome. Welcome to my furious claws of Wolverine Fury. Okay. Sorry, I promise I won't ever do that again. Just kidding, I'll probably do it like three times. Because the Therizinos are my favorite flippin' dinos in history. What do you think, Bamboo?
They are pretty broken and I love them.
I love how awesome they are. Don't say they're broken, they'll fix them.
They're like the Freddy Krueger claws.
They're my favoritest ever. Oh my god, they're so... They do Nerd Parade spirit fingers. I love them. Okay, let's do spirit fingers. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. So what we're doing over here, besides farming poly, is we're looking around, or we were, sort of, looking around for rock elementals to tame to prep for some more of our raiding. I don't know if you guys know yet, but the C4 Ptera bombs has been finally officially patched. No longer can you put C4 on the character and fly the Pteranodon in and explode stuff. So finally, as of, I think... the 11th of January, that has been patched. It's no longer a nuisance for people, which puts us in a unique advantage to where our cave base is on the center map. It's now very, very difficult to raid. In fact, if not unraidable, in my opinion, because you can only get Pteranodons through that little archway. We'll be doing a showcase of the base in a later episode, but as of now, we are just direly low on polymer for things like rocket making, which is going to lead me into talking about some of our new strategies. Now, Bamboo is going to be weighing in a lot on this, but we've got a strategy to counter to replace the C4 Pteranodon, and that's the C4 suicide person, the suicide bomber. And this is not my original strategy. I cannot claim any... I can't claim... That was a 140. I'm sad now. I can't put any claim to this strategy at all. Bamboo actually taught me this strategy. So credit where credit is due, buddy. You taught me a strategy that is highly effective that I didn't know about that I'm going to share with you guys today. and it's something that we're probably going to be doing a lot more in some of our future raids. But that's when you attach C4 to the back of a player with very high movement speed, and you run them past turrets. Now, can you do this on official? Probably not. This is... What would you say the minimum is? Move speed-wise.
I mean, you need about 200 or so. You want 240. It's really nice.
240
is
the...
health is good. I have done it on official.
Really?
Yeah, with... as you're pushing 180 with no HP, but you do use a shield.
Okay.
You also use... We'd use Brontos, and you just run underneath the Brontos.
See, that's smart. Getting something to soak the bullets as you run it. So basically what this strategy entails, and this is why we're getting the poly, because we need the poly for the C4 to make. So we were like, you know what, let's take this opportunity to show everybody how we actually farm poly and how we're able to farm it so quickly and efficiently. We're 5 minutes into the video, and we left off at 3K last time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, almost 7.5, almost 8K in like 5 minutes of just farming. We do this for like 30, 40 minutes at a time. We just fly around and whack things with the amazing Therizino. So this is what I recommend you guys do. I know we're probably giving away our best farming strategies here, and Scorch Earth is going to be really popular, a lot more popular now, but this is how we do it. So we need the poly for the C4, and we attach the C4 to the back of the player, pump the movement speed, pump a little bit of health, and we have somebody soak with either Quetzals or a Bronto, and then we run in and just punch a wall to detonate ourselves. It's not always successful, but it can be pretty devastating. And we're looking forward to trying it in some of the raids, because I'm impressed by it. I'm not going to lie. I'm impressed by the tactic. So as we fly around here collecting some more poly, we're going to take a short break. We'll BRBs with something a little more entertaining than just spirit fingers and poly farming. And we'll catch you guys then. Back, we've got a worm coming, and we're going to go for it. We're going to try to take on this worm. And maybe we can actually tame one of these mantises out here that are high enough level. If we could spot a 150, that'd be crazy. Well, I'm doing decent damage to it. And it's not really hurting me too terribly bad. Oh, you've got it aggro too on you. Oh, hello. GG. We've got the tank and the spank going right now. This is awesome. And I seem to be underneath it. Oh, no, wait. No, it's hitting me a little bit. If I stay close to its abdomen, I seem to be okay. Get him. We need alpha, or not alpha deathworm horns. We just need deathworm horns, and we can tame him. Maybe tame a mantis. Come here, you. Come here, you giant sand penis. I miss these guys. Being back on Scorched Earth, I really kind of miss it. There's so much cool stuff on Scorched Earth. All right. Swing your little mandibles over here, and he's getting awful bloody. We've got him going down.
Have some to do some damage.
I'm perfectly fine on health. The epic battle ensues. Wow, this guy's not going down. There he goes. One deathworm horn and an absurd amount of keratin and hide. And off we go to find some more mantises. Let's do a poly count really quick. A lot of poly. We have one, two...
Incoming.
Okay, we're going to do a poly count later. We should check these levels now, actually. If one takes too many hits, I'm going to get off and try to tame it. This one's taking a lot of hits. That one might be high level. 95? Okay. What level's that one? Let's check it.
140.
What should we bother?
Yeah, we kind of have boost speed. We could get some bug repellent back in base. You can try to do it if move speed. If you just let it kind of cool off.
Yeah.
Come up right behind it, and you can hop off and tame it.
Do you think 140 is worth it, though? Or should we look for a 150?
140 is fine.
Okay. Got the deathworm horn. Ready to go. It should only take one.
Yep, it's only one.
Okay.
So we'll see if it cools off, and then you just kind of run up with it in your last inventory and spam E and hope to glad you get it.
Okay. I've got the heat stroke something fierce right now. I never actually figured out what the heat stroke does. It's never...
I know when you hit 100, you die.
Oh, really? It makes your screen, like, super shiny, though.
Yeah, you turn into James Bond.
All right, bug. I'm going to run up on you and hit E. Can we do it? Oh, he's bad. Yep, no. I wasn't fast enough.
Oh, boy.
Didn't have the move speed. It's all right. I'm okay. Oh, you saved me. My hero. Should we get the bug spray?
Oh god, someone's coming with wyverns.
Oh god, someone is coming with wyverns. Abandon... Oh jeez, abandon that mission! They're chasing some dude on an arch... Wait, oh, he's trying to get him trapped! Okay, I know what he's doing. He's trying to get them in his wyvern trap. I thought that those were all manned, and I'm not gonna lie to you, the beehole got a little puckered on that. Should we just continue and, like... Or should we bother, like, coming back for it? What do you...
We can continue and grab some bug repellent.
Okay.
And try to find one.
Alright, that's not a bad idea. Let's check the old heat stroke count. We're at 23%, if you can see past my big dome there. We're good. We're good for a little bit more farming. And if we happen to pass another dude, we'll get some bug repellent and try to tame it. Taking a mantis back to the center might be a cool thing. Although, Therizinosaurs are beyond the best dino in the game right now. I'm so loving this.
Yeah, we put one with oxygen and had it fighting Moses.
No flipping way. Are you serious?
Yeah.
How did it do?
It did all right. Nuri brought it in there, and he's fighting three Moses, and we're kind of going back and forth with it.
That's really funny. How did
they
kill
an alpha Mosasaur too with it?
An alpha Mosasaur? Wow, that's impressive. These guys blow Rexes out of the water. They're so OP. I wonder how they do with the bioluminescence farming. I mean, bioluminescence is pretty easy to get. But I'm curious to know... Like, those Trank Darts are OP. I'm really liking the new Bioluminescence Trank Darts. And after you get those, stick them in the refrigerator. You'll never use regular Trank Darts again. They're awesome for taming stuff. But alright, this is back to us farming at this point. We're gonna eventually meander our way onto something a little more interesting. And we'll BRBs once more. Alright, Nerd Paraders, we're back in action. And we're still farming up some poly, but we spotted a drop. So we want to go get it with you guys together. Maybe we'll get something sweet, maybe it'll be a bunk, but we'll find out. Let's see what we got. Deep sea, deep sand, loot crate. Oh, it's a bunk. It's a Mastercraft fur hat with 130 armor. What do you need fur for on the frickin' scorched earth? Makes total sense, right? Sadness. I'm a little bummed. But we're still at it. Yeah, we're still at it. Getting some polys. There's three dudes over here. Are these any of these high level? We went back.
We got a 120 right in front of us over here.
A 120? Nah. It's not the 140 we found. We went back and we got some bug repellent. So we're ready to tame. If we can actually find a decent one. Oh, sorry, I outran your claws, but there's a dude right over here. I brought it from you.
Yeah.
Murder face. Oh, this guy's taking some hits. What level is he?
120.
Oh, that was the 120. Okay. There we go. All right. The quest ever continues. We're still going to hunt for a mantis. We're going to be back when we actually find one. We're going to tame him up, and we're going to take him back to the center, and everybody be so jealous that we're going crazy with mantises and farming stuff. It is time. We're going home with a mantis, whether it kills us or not. We got a 140 over here. I'm going to bug spray it up using our item. Okay. And I'm going to crouchy walk just so we're a little less likely to get this guy peed off, actually. I'm not going to crouch walk yet. That's a long walk to do the crouchy walk. Let's speed it up a little bit. All right. Now we can crouchy walk. Got 500 seconds on my bug spray. I just don't want to screw this up. Because I don't have any ghillie. Okay. We have to be ever so slow. We have to sing the sneaky song. Dun 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 dun. Dun 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 dun. Dun na 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 na. Dun 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 dun. Super sneaky. Okay, I got him. Oh, this is going to be a thing. No, don't turn around. Oh. The suspense is building! I'm gonna stick this horn right up its pooper! Yay, and we got him! Okay. I'm gonna call you Mandible. 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 Come here, Mandible. Awesome. I'm so happy about this. Okay, what? We need to get, like, a final count on our polymer, because it is about time to turn around and go home. We've been here for many, many moons. We made a bunch of whips. I forgot to talk about those. We have a blueprint for a whip over here on Scorched Earth, so we made a bunch of whips. Oh, you already took it all out. Okay.
All on the Quetzal.
All on the Quetzal. Okay, let's do this. Or, there we go. This is our score for the run. And we've been over here, like, what would you say, like, 40 minutes? Tops? 40, maybe 45? I feel like that's
about
pretty...
About so, yeah.
About something like that. Okay. So if it's 500 and there's 5 per line, that's 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 2500. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 lines. Okay, what's maybe I shouldn't have done it like that. Now I'm hang on, we gotta get the calculator out. Wait, don't make fun of me, math is bad. 15 times 2500, 37,500. So 37,800, 39,000 poly. I had to get the calculator out. Please don't make fun of me for my plebby math skills. 39K organic polymer in a 40-minute, 45-minute spree of farmy time. We got an undersea or deep sea loot crate, and we got a 140 mantis. We're going home as champs. We're going home as champs. Now it's time to get back to a drop or an obelisk. So, oh, we're gonna have to get this guy to follow us, aren't we?
I'm thinking we can drop the Thera in the saddle
Yeah.
platform, and then we'll be able to carry it back.
Okay. Let's try that. Because I'm kind of confused on, like, we're gonna walk the Thera onto the platform?
Yeah, I'll see if I can get you out of here.
Okay, gotcha.
I think the turrets are off of these, yeah.
Ooh. Oh yeah, we're gonna use somebody's wyvern pen very creatively. Splat. Okay. It would be super convenient if there was another deep sea or deep sand loot crate out here. All right, here I go. Coming on you hot here. Am I on? I think I'm
One
on.
second.
Oh my gosh, I'm Quetzal surfing. This is amazing. I am super impressed that this is a thing that's working. Oh, do you have weird Quetzal, is it hard to fly?
Yeah.
Because I'm on your back. Yeah, I figured it might be.
Yeah.
To any type of obelisk we go, or any type of drop. Uh-oh. Oh God, I'm not moving.
Don't move.
I'm okay. I'm not moving. Look, it's hands free. All right, guys, we're gonna VRV once we manage to meander our way to some sort of drop or obelisk to get all this stuff offloaded and head back to the center base. And barring any type of ridiculous failure, we'll be back in just a second. We made it to the blue obelisk, and we're gonna first things first upload mandibles. So come here, mandibles. We're gonna upload you. Mandibles. Upload dino. And accept. Mandibles is up, and we're gonna show you how. I mean, we have a ridiculous amount. There's like almost 7K weight on this Quetzal. We have a ridiculous amount of chitin that's going back to moving into paste. The meat's probably not gonna come with us, but we've got some heavy stuff. We're gonna show you how we're gonna get it all back, and this is kind of basically, more or less the trick that we're going to use. First things first, I'm pulling all the stuff off the Thera, and I'm going to upload him, and that's already got me weighted down. All these
Oh, no, the
whips.
Thera stays.
Oh, Thera stays. I'm sorry. I thought we were going to upload the Thera first. Are we going to do the.
I can drop them right to you. We'll do that.
Okay.
So I'll drop a test on here.
Ooh. You know what? I got a better idea. Keep doing what you're doing. I've got something in mind. There you go. Machine gun it. And it's still coming in me. That is a weird way to phrase that. I'm still collecting items. I immediately wish I could take that back. Phrasing Nick 2017. We'll call it a Nickism. Okay. I'm still picking stuff up. Still going crazy here.
I love the whip.
I know it's amazing. It's overpowered and awesome. My one of my fav It's like the it's an essential tool. It really truly is. Get out of here, Morellatops. Flame arrows come in. Oh, there goes the whip. It broke. I got a good thing I have a bunch more. And there's a storm coming, it sounds like. Okay, we're picking stuff up again. I might need to get nudged or punched over to the obelisk. I might be
Okay.
just a bit too far away because that Morella tops. So far, okay. I have 95,000 chitin on me. What's my weight at? 7,500. I think, is that everything? Do we have everything?
Yep, that's everything.
Yeah, punch me over to the. Oh no, I can access the terminal. Never mind.
All right, yeah.
Travel to another ARK, and we're going to the center. Nerd Praetors, we're back on the center, and we've got ourselves a drop. We've unloaded all of the poly and all the chitin, and now we're going to get our mandible. Download creature, mandible, download dino, and he's going to come right... There he is! Hey, buddy! What's up, mandible? Oh, God, he's in me! Mandible. Let me try to loot this so I can get out of mandible. There we go. Luckily, this thing was real close to our base. And Mandible's coming home with us. And our base just happens to be right here. So it couldn't have been more convenient, but we've got a cool little mantis that we can make use of on the center now. And we'll stick him inside as our base loads in. Okay, it looks like people are still doing some growing. Oh, all these rexes are full grown. We were imprinting a bunch of rexes. Oh, hey, don't follow me, Mandible. Actually, you can follow me, but you can follow me over here into the base. We're going to get you nice and secured. We'll have to craft you up a saddle. We've got some... we're going to have to go back to Scorched. We're going to have to go back to Scorched to get some silk and things to make a saddle for this guy, I bet. Bamboo's trying to help me get him in. Come on, Mandible. Get inside your home. Welcome to your new home, buddy. We got to get a saddle on you. But I think... it's going to be a happy day. We'll have some fun playing with you guys. I hope you liked the episode, and I hope you learned a little bit using the Therizinosaur. Farming organic polymer on Scorched Earth in a cross-cluster environment is absolutely absurd. It is one of the best methods that we have ever found, and it is so much fun to do. Just in that short amount of time, we got such a ridiculous amount. But if you liked the video, please hit that thumbs up button for us if you learned something from it. If you haven't done so yet, get whipped in the face like I just did. If you haven't done so yet, guys, please subscribe to the page for some more cool videos just like this one. And as always, remember to take care of yourselves, stay awesome, and we'll catch you in the next one. Later.